In the viewer, you can view clips from both events and from the project's timeline. You will be able to see how to crop and resize clips, keeping the aspect ratio or not. You'll also see how to make fine viewer adjustments within the inspector. The viewer is where you see your clips currently. The playhead is over this clip in the timeline, and that frame that it's parked on is showing in the viewer here. If we have this button turned on, in other words blue, that represents skimming and it's controlled with the S key on and off. When we skim over clips, we can quickly see the content of those clips. Currently we're looking in the timeline, but we can also select clips in the event and we can skim over the clips in the event. The viewer has a number of controls. If we have this blue button selected here and we select transform, then when we're in the viewer, we get these little blue dots, and these little blue dots allow us to transform or resize the clip within the boundaries of the viewer. So that when we viewed this, if we were to export this, we would see the black outline and the clip in the middle. If we click on here and drag it further, then we're effectively zooming into that clip. And when we export this, this is the view that we would see, bounded by these lines here. We can see the different sizes of the viewer. Currently it's set at fit to size, and let's bring it down to 50%. Now, this mark here is the edge of the viewer, but this mark here is the edge of the clip. So as you can see, you can bring the clip to be smaller than the size of the viewer or larger than the size of the viewer, and hence zoomed in. When you click on the corner buttons, then you resize and retain the aspect ratio. When you click on the left, right, bottom or top buttons, then you change the aspect ratio. So we're making the clip narrower or wider or shorter. We can always revert back to the original size by using Command Z or Command Z. With the transform, you also have a crop button. So when you select crop, the outer lines change to dotted lines, and this will let you crop the clip but not resize it. If you click in within a cropped clip, then you simply move the cropping, not the clip. When you're in the crop area, your choices are crop or trim. Currently we're looking at the trim, and that will let us cut from the edge, or we can look at the crop, that will crop a portion of the clip so we can just see the center here, and then when that plays, only that center area will show. We could use tracking if we wanted to, or keyframes to track that boat, but that's something for a more advanced tutorial. Also in the cropping area, we have the Ken Burns effect. Now, the Ken Burns effect is best used on a still image rather than a video image, but that doesn't mean to say you can't use it on a moving video image. But for this exercise, we will do a double whammy, in that we will see how to create a still image or a freeze frame from a clip, and then apply the Ken Burns effect to that still image. So if we move to another clip in the timeline here, let's park our playhead on this frame. So if we want to make a freeze frame of that, we can go to the edit menu and select here freeze frame, or we can simply use the option F key on the keyboard. And when we do that within the timeline, and just to zoom in here, moving image, there is the freeze frame, and there's the continuation of that moving image. So we now have a freeze frame of that particular image there from this point to this point, and we can put a Ken Burns effect on that. So if we have this selected now and click on Ken Burns, with the Ken Burns effect, the things to note are that you start your image at the green line, start, and you end your image at the end, or the red line. So we can now have this move to just the yacht, starting here and finishing here. We now play that clip. It will start at the wide angle and zoom towards the yacht. When you're on the transform button, you will have the opportunity to create keyframes. Now we will see keyframes in a later tutorial, but this is how they're located here. So let's just move over onto the right hand side here. Currently we're viewing the viewer at 50%. We can fit it to the size of the viewer, or we can change the size, let's say to 12% there, or we can zoom all the way up to 300%. And we're now zoomed in, and of course the image is now quite pixelated. And when you're fully zoomed in, this little red button here will allow you to move around the clip to position it where you might want to view. So if we now come back to 100%, then we're still zoomed in, and this will allow us to position our clip to how we might want it. The next button on the right hand side here will show you your video angles when you're working with multicam. So you would have this turned on, show angles, if you are working with multicam. It will also let you select the quality and the performance level. You can select how you play your media, either as optimized media or proxy media, and that can be selected from this location as well. And finally, within the viewer, we can select these angled arrows here and it will play in full screen. You can make fine viewer adjustments within the inspector. So if we select the clip in the timeline, and looking over in the inspector here, we have our transform option, just as we have a transform option here. Currently, we're looking at the clip where it is zoomed in. So this is the outer line of the clip. This is what the viewer is seeing. We can bring this back to 100% by simply clicking on this reset button, and that resets it to the original size. If we show the contents of the transform now, we can make our scale adjustments by moving the slider here. We can also change our rotation there, just as we can change it here. And at any time, we can reset it back to the original. We can also show the cropping function and click on crop. Then we can crop the left hand side, or we can trim top right hand, and we can also select our Ken Burns effect there as well. In the next lesson, we will look at the middle menu bar, and that's this area in the center here. We will look at all of the controls in the middle menu bar.